loved ones, and they loved Anoka so much, they decided to stay. In 1904, they had this house, which was named Colonial Hall, built to serve both home and medical office. Flora had her practice in the house while Alanson traveled to Minneapolis on the trolley each day. If you're friends of the Aldrich, you could enter through the front door behind me, but if you're coming to see the doctor, you would enter the door on this side of the house. As well as treating patients, the Aldrich were active in the community. Flora activated for women's suffrage, and Alanson was the 32nd degree Mason. After Alanson passed away in 1916, Flora kept her practice going in the home and worked until her death in 1921. Flora's brother, with no need of a home in Anoka, sold Colonial Hall to the Masonic Lodge. The home was used as the Anoka County Historical Society for 30 years, and then in 2004, it became an antique store. Both the History Center and the Big White House have experienced odd happenings in the house. Even though it's no longer a home, the current owners believe that both doctors still make this place their home. People will come downstairs and ask, like almost like they're telling on someone, are you supposed to be smoking in the house? People smell smoke most commonly in the back hall or in Allison's old library and study on the second floor. The owner just responds politely, we'll take care of it, thank you for letting us know, but if the doctor wants to continue to smoke, there's nothing she can do about it. Early in the morning, when the owner comes in to open, she hears pacing upstairs back and forth. Employees will think that someone is up there. You hear someone pacing and then walk partway down the stairs and then go back upstairs and resume pacing. In the beginning, they used to move furniture for the owner. They know where everything is, but come in the next morning and a dresser will be clear across the room. The security system has motion detectors that will go off in rare times where there's a baby bat lost, but never turns on when furniture is being moved. How does it move without setting off the alarm? Owner's husband was a big disbeliever, rolling his eyes at stories until he came over to help hanging items. Now he says, I'm not saying I believe, but a picture was hanging on the far wall across the home from them, and then suddenly heard a shattered glass. The picture had launched off the wall to crash to the floor across the room. The screw was still on the wall, the hanger was still intact on the back of the photograph, and it was 12 feet from where it had been hanging. The owner has never felt threatened, nothing but a couple that loves this home and just didn't want to leave. She declines when people ask if she wants help getting them to move on. She says good morning every day when she comes in, and thank you each evening for allowing her to use their home and allowing to be their caretaker. So we'll just head over next door to the Masonic Lodge.